this show started off right. We have a group of young ladies called the Bulldog Bomb Squad, and they're just going to showcase a little piece for you just right now.
On a presidential rolling and it's gone. Money's not a problem, I get money by the house. Billy never kitty, mercy, lago, or the house.
Turn up!
I'm swerving on these owls.
Turn up!
I'm swerving on these owls.
Give another hand for the Bulldog Bomb Squad. I'm gonna need one of y'all to come clean this up. Y'all got money all over the stage, and it ain't real. Hey, come get this money. Next, we have a special treat, as you know or may not know. This is a staff and student talent show. So not only do our scholars have some excellent talent, but our staff also has some very special hidden talents. And right now, we're going to grace you with the presence of Mr. Thomas.
Jeremy Thomas!
Hey, what's up? So a lot of people ask me why I work here, and the number one reason is high school relationships, and that's what this song is all about. So if you know the words, you should definitely sing along.
Saying, this is it, yeah, I had enough. Cause we hadn't seen each other in a month. And you said that we needed space. And then you come around again, saying, I miss you, swear that I'm changing. Trust me, I feel that I had you in a month. Said, I hate you, break up, you call me, I love you, but ooh. We call it off again last night. Ooh. This time I'm telling you, we are never, ever, ever getting back together. We are never, ever, ever getting back together. You go talk to your friends, talk to my friends, talk to me. Picking fights and me for falling for it, yelling I'm right, and you can go ahead and hide for some indie record that's much cooler than mine. But ooh, you called me up again last night, and ooh, and this time I'm telling you, we. Getting back together, we are never, ever, ever getting don't you ever say I just walked away. I will always want you, and I can't live a lie running for my life. I will always want you. I came in like a wrecking ball.
Somebody pass out over there. You got a fan club. Let's just give it up for my lovely assistant, Chevelle Riley. She's one of our cheerleaders. Next, I want to bring one of our CPA students back up to the stage. She performed last year, and she's brave enough coming out of her shell to do it again. So I'd like to bring Ja'Esha Smith singing I'd Rather Go Blind by Etta James.
Something told me it was over. When I saw you in her talking, something deep down in my soul said, cry, girl. When I saw you in her walking around, ooh, I would rather go blind, boy, than to see you walk away from me. Child, no. Oh, so you see, I love you so much that I don't want to watch you leave me, baby. Most of all, I just don't want to be free, no. Oh, I was just sitting here thinking of your kiss in your warm embrace, yeah. When the reflection in the glass that I held to my lips now, baby, revealed these tears that are on my face. And baby, I'd rather be blind, boy, than to see you walk away from me, yeah. And baby, I'd rather be blind, boy, than to see you walk away from me.
Thank you, Ja'Esha. Let's give it up for Ja'Esha one more time. This next young man, when he came, he told us he was auditioning for the talent show and we didn't believe him. And he was like, no, really, I am. I'm for real. So we was like, okay, well, show us what you got. And he had us literally crying, literally. So I like to bring to the stage the comedic styles of Mr. Maurice Holder.
Yeah. Have you ever wondered why they call this a microphone? I mean, it looked like a magic wand, not a phone. Abracadabra. This is awesome. How y'all doing today? I ain't hear an answer, I heard. I'm gonna ask that again, how y'all doing today? That's better, that's better. Hi, Raven. Hi. What y'all favorite color is? System incompatible. Y'all said all kind of colors at the same time. What the? What was that? Daylin, what's your favorite color? Why you just look around like you don't know what your name is, bro? I know you know who Daylin Johnson is. Daylin, answer me, bro. Okay. Ms. Kramer, what's your favorite color?
Red.
Awesome. Red. I'm a vampire. Watch out. I like acrobats a lot. You wanna know why?
Why?
Because they're creepy. They can do a back bend. Your spine isn't supposed to move that way. It's very dangerous. Okay, the other day, I was watching cartoons, and I saw SpongeBob. He's a square, and he talks, and he's a sponge in the ocean. How does it even make sense? I mean, that's not even a laugh, that's a scream. And his snail, which isn't supposed to make any sound at all, meows. And a star lives under a rock. And he lives in a pineapple. And it's rotten by now. I bet it stinks. I'm not even gonna use the word stinks, I'm gonna use stank. Stank is a better word, cause it stinks. Very, very bad. I went to his house and we ate pineapple for dinner. Yes, sir. And guess what? The pineapple was part of his house. We died. I came back to life. I was watching Dragon Ball Z the other day, and they have superpowers. All they have to do is say, I am. It's amazing. And their hair changes color. That's awesome. They don't even have to go to the store and buy any dye products. They can just be like, they're just like green. Really? That quick? And you're screaming in the middle of the store, just buy the dye. Don't scream. Store manager walks up. That's awesome. Teach me how to do that. He goes, no! Store manager's on the floor. He's like this. I want it yellow. He goes home, I go home. I'm scared for the rest of my life. It scarred me. Red. Miss Kramer, your favorite color. It shines very bright at me. My favorite color is now blue or red or purple or whatever one of the colors y'all said, okay? I didn't understand you earlier, so I only understand this one person because she speaks proper English. All I heard from you guys was, ah, ah, ah. You sound Arabian. That's chicken. I love fried chicken. Do you? Cause I do. Smile. I like birds, and they can fly.
I wish I had wings. Guess what I did? I attached a bird to my back. Nope, seriously, it's right here. You can't really see it because it's like dead now, so I took it off. It was still alive, but dead at the same time. I mean, it was like this. It was just walking around. I was like, bro, what's wrong with you? He said, you. And I said, what you mean you? He said, for real? You sold me onto your back and you say, what do you mean you? Don't make me go Chris Brown on you. I ain't playing. Go away. He looked like an old man. No. Bye. Go away. He has magical powers too. Did I mention he can fly? Did I mention he has wings? That makes a special sound. It's like this. I think I swallowed a bug. Hold on. Speaking of swallowing bugs, have you ever heard of people eating bugs? I mean, jungle men eat roaches and mice and crickets, and it's covered with chocolate. I know. I eat it though, because it had chocolate on it. I kind of peel the chocolate off and eat that. Throw the cricket at the cook, like, cricket. Oh, it busted open. My favorite question in the world, you wanna know it? Yeah. What that mouth do though? Somebody asked me that question before, I was like, it eats food, and possibly candy, and it talks and breathes. And I'm walking away from you right now because you're really weird. He goes, but what it do? What it do? A lot of emphasis on the O right there. Hi, Harmony. You look like a garden gnome. And I don't understand a single word you're saying. You're like, yeah. Tu hablo español. Tu no hablo inglés. ¿Por qué? Okay. Overall, I am awesome.
And you are not.
Bye.
Let's give it up one more time for Maurice. And in case you didn't know, there are concessions being sold in the corner back there, so feel free to get up at any time and get you some snacks. Judges, there's a slight change in the program. We're going to go with skip over Skylar for a moment due to technical difficulties. So we're going with Anastasia next. Destiny's not here. Sorry. Next up, we will have a praise dance by Miss Anastasia Schubert.
No one around, I need this more.
so much, Anastasia. That was beautiful. I think I saw somebody crying, but I'm not going to call you out. It was that lady standing in the corner over there. I saw you crying from a distance. Okay, the next person coming up to the stage will be Miss Skylar Jackson singing Over You.
Skylar, one more time.
think I've been with Lighthouse 3 years, and I have seen Skylar perform every year. And it gets better each time. I really enjoy Skylar. I just want to check, is Destiny Green here? Okay, we're going to move right along. The next person to come up is probably one of the shyest people you'll ever meet or see and never hear, but you will today. We've got Miss Raven Holder singing Dynamite.
My hands up in the air sometimes, saying hey, oh, gotta let go. I wanna celebrate and live my life, saying hey, oh, baby, let's go. I get a move, 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 get out the way, me and my crew, 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 crew. I hit the club, let's go.
Together, they will be scored separately. We don't want all of our kids to make our staff look bad, now do we? If Mr. Thomas was here, he'd hit me with his guitar right now. So next to the stage, I'm gonna bring one of our newest staff members to our CPA. And it's been a pleasure meeting her this year. I've just met her about 2 or 3 weeks ago. She's been here all year. But she has a beautiful voice, and I'd like to bring Miss Caldwell to the stage singing I'm Here from the Broadway musical of The Color Purple.
Hey, everybody. I
like my sister. I can feel her now. She may not be here, but she's still mine, and I know she still loves me. I've got my children, and I can't hold them now. They may not be here, but they still mine, and I hope, you know I still love them. Got my house, it still keeps the cold out. I've got my chair with my body.
Next up, we're gonna have a dance. by Miss Malaysia Schubert will be dancing to Pieces. Singing You Bring Me Joy. And she got her backup crew with her. Who couldn't be here. He's at a meeting this evening. But my K7 principal is here. Thank you for coming out, Ms. Coates. I want to give a shout out to Mr. Mickens, DJ Soul of Soul Hits Entertainment. Also, Mr. DJ Ricky Hollywood up here. I wanted to give a shout out to Ms. Fogum and Ms. Caldwell and Ms. Clark. They actually helped with the auditions for our students, as well as Ms. Caldwell became a part of it. Ms. Clark is back there working, and Ms. Fogum helped manage the girls that came up first. So I want to say thank you to them. I want to say thank you to one of my favorite parents, Rhonda Warren, out there working the door. Ms. White, who was my backup judge, but she stepped up anyway and she helped out, and so I want to say thank you to her. I want to say thank you to all the lovely judges on the panel. Thank you so much. I want to say thank you to Common Ground back in the corner, CG. And I want to say thank you to all the parents and the staff and the students of Lighthouse. We wouldn't have been able to do this without all of you. So a big thank you to all of you. So right now, without further ado, I'm going to bring along our last act, which is a very humble lady. Until you hear her sing, you would not believe what comes out of her mouth. So I will bring to you right now Mrs. Elliott singing Back to Before from the Broadway musical Ragtime.
Pretty good, Maurice. Thank you. Enjoyed your comedy earlier, man. It's real good.
What that mouth do?
There was a time our happiness seemed never ending. I was so sure that where we were heading was right. Life was a road so certain, so straight and unending. Our little road with never a crossroad in sight. Back in the days when we spoke in civilized voices, women in white and sturdy young men at the oar. Back in the days when I let you make all my choices. We can never go back to before. There was a time my feet were so solidly planted. You'd sail away while I turned my back to the sea. I was content, a princess asleep and enchanted. If I had dreams, then I let you dream them for me. Back in the days when everything seemed so much clearer, women in white who knew what their lives had in store. Where are they now, those women who stared from the mirrors? We can never go back to before. Afraid of revealing that they might have a feeling, or they might have been wrong. There are people out there unafraid to feel sorrow, unafraid of tomorrow, unafraid to be weak, unafraid to be strong. There was a time when you were the person in motion. I was your wife. It never occurred to want more. inside my room.